Hey, what's up, everyone? It's Derek from Nerd or Die, and I'm excited to bring you our next free resource, the Social Media Popup version 2, as well as I'm announcing our first giveaway for a GTX 1070. More information on the giveaway in the description below, as well as at the end of this video. Let's get right into it. So we just put out an updated version of the popular social media pop-up. However, this time I wanted to include new features that were requested, but just didn't really make it into the last one. You'll be able to set this up, customize it to your liking, and add it into your stream in just a few minutes. The first step is to head over to the nerdordie.com shop and go through the checkout process for this item. It is a pay what you want item, so you just need to enter in zero to get it for free. Once you've downloaded the files, you'll need to extract them from the zip file, and you can use a program like 7-Zip or WinRAR to make this happen. I'll go ahead and put this on my desktop for now. Inside of this folder, you'll find some files, and let's go ahead and start with the README file. Click on that to launch the first page that we need to visit. This page allows us to add social networks that we want to have seen in our pop-up, as well as what text we want to put by those networks. You can follow the instructions here, which I'll go through right now. To add any of the preset network icons, simply just click on them. While doing this, you'll see them added in the icon sheet preview section, and you'll also see the names for each one that you clicked on under the Add Custom Icons section. Notice the Remove button here. This is in case you need to remove any of the icons. Now, once you're done adding in any of the preset icons, you can also upload your own custom icons by clicking the Upload Image button, or you can just drag and drop the image into this area. I recommend using PNG images here, especially if you want to add a solid color on top of your pop-up icons. And more on that just a little bit later. Anyways, once you've added all the networks that you need, it's now time to assign what text you want by each network. To do so, just click in the box that says Enter Text Here and type in what you want. So for my Twitch icon, I'll type in Nerd or Die, since that's the name of my Twitch channel. I'll fill in the information for the rest of the icons as well. And once I'm done with that, I just need to hit the download button. And when you hit the download button here, I want you to know that you'll probably receive two messages. The first warning will be something about you're attempting to download multiple files, and just click OK or allow because you will need to download two files from here to make this product work properly. And the second warning you might receive is about a harmful file. And again, you'll just want to click OK or allow, as this file is just a simple JS file that stores your names that you entered above. So hit keep to download that one. And once both of these are downloaded, we need to put them in the settings and images folder found in the file we recently extracted. So with that done, we can move on to the next part of the setup, which is clicking the customize appearance and timings link at the top of your ad networks page. Here we just follow the instructions again, and this page allows us to do a few things. You'll notice a preview of the pop-up on the right that helps you choose your colors a bit. Let's start with the options though. First is the pause time. This lets you decide how long in seconds you want each network to pause for. So basically it will show your network for 6 seconds and then move on to the next one. I'm going to change this to 3 for my example, and then we're going to move on to the next option that is in between pause time. This is the amount of time in between the total animation, meaning once the pop-up has shown all the networks that you added in, it will pause for this amount of time. So if you want this to appear every 10 minutes, set this number to 600 for 600 seconds. In my example though, I'm going to put it at 6, just so you can see the demo reappear. Next, the color section lets you assign various colors to each part of the pop-up. Just click the Change Color button for each section and choose what best fits your channel. You can also enter hex codes or RGBA values in the boxes below if you have exact colors that you'd like to use. On the far right of the color picker is the opacity slider, and this allows you to make your colors see-through if you'd like. An important color to talk about here is the icon color. Right now, the icon color will fill in each icon with a solid color. So this is why it's important to use a PNG that includes transparency for your own custom icons. If you use something like a JPEG, it will simply fill the entire image, and you might not be able to make out your own added icons. However, if you want to not include any filler to your icons, simply slide the opacity slider all the way down. With the slider all the way down, the icons will show up exactly as they were in the Add Your Network section. So the Twitch icon would actually be purple, the Reddit icon would show the full alien face, and your custom icons will display exactly as you had them. Once you're done tweaking your colors, the final selection is fonts. Here, you can use this search button to find any font that Google Fonts has. One of my favorites is simply called Play, so I'm going to search for that and pick it from the list. Next, we have the font weight, which is the thickness or boldness of your font. You should know that not all fonts include multiple font weights, so when in doubt, just leave this at the default of 400. However, for this font Play, I noticed that it does have a nice bold version at 600 weight, which I'll use here. Finally, pick the font size and then use the text Y offset slider to adjust the text as needed. Some fonts don't center align perfectly, so this will help you tweak that value. Now let's hit download, and again, if you have a warning here, just hit allow to download this JavaScript file. Let's place our newly downloaded settings.js file in the settings and images folder. With that, we're done with setting up the social pop-up, and I want to quickly note that it's important to have all three of these files in your settings and images folder, and I want you to make sure that they're also named properly. Sometimes if you download multiple files from the site, you'll have a number added at the end of your file, such as 1 or 2 in parentheses, and this is just to prevent duplicate files. To prevent this issue, just make sure you delete any of the previous files in your download folder before downloading new files again. So let's again double check your files and that they're named properly before moving on to this last part. Let's go ahead and add the pop-up into OBS Studio. I'll create a new browser source and choose local file. Next, I'll browse and I'll find the folder that I downloaded from the Nerd or Die shop, and I'll see some files that I can pick. The right social media pop-up v2 file is what I'm going to choose for this example. And the difference between this and the left version is that one is aligned to the left and the other is aligned to the right. So choose whatever best fits your stream. I'll enter 1000 for the width and 300 for the height. And if your networks are really long, you may need to increase the width just a bit. After I hit OK, I should be able to watch my new pop-up in action. We'll see it cycle through all my networks before pausing for the time that I set it to and then restarting. Now, I really hope you guys enjoyed this free resource. It's one that I've been wanting to make for a long time. And I'd also like to say a huge thank you to Prognosi Gator from Patreon, who this resource is dedicated. Thank you very much for your support. Oh yeah, and I also want to talk about our first ever giveaway that we're doing with Nerd or Die that is something other than our graphics. From now until June 6, 2017, you can enter to win an EVGA GTX 1070 at nerdordie.com/giveaway. It's ran through gleam.io, so you simply need to subscribe to this channel or follow us on various social media to be eligible to enter. We also partnered up with 2 awesome streamers, so I highly recommend checking them out as well. If you happen to be watching this video after June 6th, don't worry, we'll be running more giveaways with graphics and some other cool stuff, so you can check out that link anyways. And please let me know in the comments below if you have any questions about this video. If you like the video, give it a like. And if you want more great streaming resources, make sure to subscribe to Nerd or Die. Thanks for watching.